Father Antoine Henriot was born on February 13, 1924, in a small hamlet in France called Montbéliardon. His parents, Charles and Celestine, were very staunch and fervent Catholics.
In front of the grotto at Lourdes, my mother asked her lady to take the child that she was carrying to God for the service of God. And the child who was born was myself.
The parents of Father Henriot were poor and had no farm of their own, and so they had to go farm to farm to support their family. Father Henriot grew up with his 14 brothers and sisters in the rented farm at Fornay-Blancheroche. Father Henriot made his first communion when he was 8 and received the sacrament of confirmation when he was 13. In 1935, at the age of 11, Father Henriot answered God's call to become a priest. Father joined the Minor Seminary of Consolation and studied here for 6 years. Then, in 1941, Father entered the Major Seminary in Favanay and pursued his studies in philosophy for 2 years. In 1944, at the age of 20, Father Henriot, then a seminarian, moved to Paris to study theology at the Society of Foreign Missionaries. Father Henriot, aged 23, was ordained a priest on Sunday, June 29, 1947, in a batch of 25 candidates.
Just after the celebration of the ordination in Paris, in the seminary, all the priests gave their blessing to their parents. I still remember that my mother came in front of me, knelt down to receive my blessing. It was a very, very good emotional sign of the love the parents and the son.
The newly ordained Father Henriot had to wait for the following Sunday, July 6, 1947, to celebrate his first Mass in his own parish in Fornay-Blancheroche. Father Henriot was blessed to see the whole parish turn up for the occasion.
On the day of the ordination, at the evening, we received a destination for China.
Father spent 5.5 years in Guangxi, Nanning, South China, from January 1948 to July 1953. About early 1950, the church in China suffered persecution under communism. Father Henriot too underwent persecution and arrest for 3.5 years.
They came to my room, one guard, one police, one soldier was guarding me the whole night. I was sleeping and so on. Then the guard was at the foot of my bed the whole night to look after me. Then after that, one day at night, they informed us, at midnight, tomorrow before midnight, you have to leave the China. So, all right, we prepare ourselves and so on. Many, many people were coming to say goodbye. A poor lady came and she told me, Father, you go. Pray for us that we keep the faith. We don't want anything else, only that. Pray for us. And sometimes you meet the young people around the church, going here and walking, saying the rosary, to ask God to help them not to follow the communist and so on. I cannot say, I don't want to pray when you see all these people to pray.
Father witnessed how the whole community suffered, but still held on to their faith.
When I came from China, when I came to Hong Kong, I went to the hospital. Then after that, the superior asked me to go on leave. Then I came back to, when I came back to Malaysia, it was not Malaysia, it was Malaya. There was only one diocese, Singapore, controlling the whole Malaya. And then it was Bishop Olsomendi. So Bishop Olsomendi say, Father, you go to Seremban. So I have to obey also. So I came to Seremban. And then he said, you go to Seremban to learn English. And to learn English, to prepare to go to somewhere else and so on, as soon as possible. In Seremban, it was a very nice day, because at the time, there were quite a number of priests. At Seremban, there was 4 or 5 priests there. Father Dubois, Father Palier was with me also, together, and son, Father Clement, Father Michael, all these fathers, they were there. But my life in Seremban was very good because we know Chinese already, we know the Cantonese, and Seremban was very Cantonese speaking. So we could manage to speak to the Christian, make retreat with the Catholics and son. Oh, it was a very nice time because the Catholics were very happy to see her and son. Still somebody now still remember in Seremban that her father, you remember, you teach us catechism, you teach us singing and son. Yes, all right.
Then Father Henriot was made parish priest of St. Aloysius Church, Muntin. Father was here from July 1957 to December 1962. Father renovated the church building and set up a new private secondary school. In December 1963, Father returned from a year's home leave and was made parish priest of St. Thomas Church, Kuantan, and was here until 1970. Based at St. Thomas Church, Father administered to the spiritual needs of the Catholic communities in Sungai Lembing, Pekan, Rompin Mining and Kemaman. During this tenure, Father built a new St. Thomas Church and the old church became a kindergarten. 1971, Father Henriot was posted to the Church of Our Lady of Perpetual Succor, Mentakab, and remained here until 1976. Father extended the kindergarten. From Mentakab, Father visited and ministered to the surrounding estates as far as Karak and Maran. In 1977, Father moved as parish priest of Holy Family Church, Kajang. This was also the time after the Ajinomoto.
My stay in Kajang was another one, 13 and a half years. I started visiting the people and son. And then it was just at the time when we started the BEC. I still remember that we divided the town in zone. Then I used to go to zone every month, say the mass there in families and son. After that, it was the time to help another one to come and to let me go there. So after that, the bishop said, "Hey, Father, you go to Sapak." So, all right, I left Kajang.
Father Henriot was known for his great devotion to our Mother Mary, and through this Marian devotion, and especially the Legion of Mary, Father brought many Catholics closer to the Catholic faith. Father was a priest on call 24 hours a day, administering to his flock at the church as well as in the homes and hospitals. February 1st, 1991, Father Henriot took charge of the Good Shepherd Church, Stapak. Many projects were successfully undertaken. The church was painted, a new organ was bought, a new PA system was installed, a grotto was built, a bell tower was raised, and the multipurpose community center was built. And again, the BECs was the thrust of parish life. Father remained in Good Shepherd Parish, Stapak until August 2004. On February 13, 2004, Father celebrated his 80th birthday during Mass, followed by a Chinese dinner with fellow priests, parishioners, friends, and his two sisters and brother. On October 13, 2004, Father joined St. Francis Xavier Home in Charas, a home for the elderly run by the Little Sisters of the Poor, as the spiritual advisor. Retired, Father is still as busy as ever. Father visits the sick, celebrates weekend masses in various parishes besides carrying out his pastoral duties at the home. Father has made a few trips to his homeland, France, on Marian pilgrimages as well as on home visits. Father is close to his family members who have often visited him here. June 29, 2007, Father Antoine Henriot celebrates 60 years of priestly ordination.
I am very happy to say that I am a priest. I am a priest forever. My mother say, so when we speak about retirement and son, so my mother was always say, "Hey, you must know, a priest must die standing up. That means a priest must not die sleeping or sitting down and so on. He must always be at work. So I have still the word of my mother in my mind. So I thought, I think so. It is the way that I did. And that's why, although we are retired in one way, retired from the teaching, for the administration of the parishes, but now we are here to look on the pastoral side.
Father has touched many hearts, young and old, through his simplicity, friendliness and deep spirituality.